Marcus Inkstrom, he's a Swedish boy, lives up in Bozeman, Montana. He's an incredible luthier and just a nut on this. I've been around some people that have worked on guitars or built, and he is the dude. But he was explaining to me, and it went way over my head, but he said the guitar is not a perfect instrument. Get used to it, in tuning wise. You know, so you find yourself, when your ear gets better, you'll start retuning for each chord, you know, each key playing, but he said it's all right. So, it's been a long weekend and fun. Not that long, really, but it's been fun. This is my last show here this weekend. So it's gotten very casual, but now. Are you okay with that? I'm sorry, what? Was there a question? Oh, it's a workshop. I like workshops. Yes? What kind of guitar is it? It's a Martin D18. Steven. And I can show you why in a bit. Thank you. but she was too cool to bluff. So I picked up my matches, was closing the door. I had one of them flashes, I've been there before, been there before. Going down the road feeling bad. Going down the road feeling bad. Going down the road feeling bad, Lord, Lord. And I ain't gonna be treated this way. So what do you got for song? I got down on my knees in a cell. Down my knees in a cell. Down my knees in a cell, Lord, Lord. Gonna be treated this way. cornbread and beans. Feed me on cornbread and beans, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. Chilly winds never blow, yes I am. Going where the climate suits my clothes, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. Enjoyed yourselves this weekend. I think this is a wonderful event. Really is, man. Blessed with some fine weather. I'm going to write a song that, I'm going to sing a song that I wrote under the influence of jet lag. I get jet lag really, really bad. It's like I don't get seasick. I never catch a cold. I don't get. You know, I'm lucky that way. It must be all this clean living. But I get jet lag horribly. When I go over to Norway and those Scandinavian, it takes me like 6 days before. What is that music in the background? Am I just hearing that? Or?
It's
a pink house.
It's a big place.
The pink house of music. Anyway, I wrote this in a very short time under the influence of jet lag, and for lack of a better title, I just call it The Musician's Lament, which the pink house could be part of this song if I just hadn't heard the pink house.
Give me a little more water in the guitar, a little more water.
Do you have those capabilities? These guys are great, these sound guys, they work hard, they have to keep us happy, and that's not easy, but give them a big hand and Ted and everybody. Lots of things us musicians will put up with. Get our music here to you tonight. We've done our job and everything's all right. Everything's all right. Ride around in a van, smells like pizza, beer, and cigarettes. I got pulled over by the police tonight on my way to you. We complied to all his requests. We want no trouble with the law. But I told that officer something that it just won't do. Yeah, it just won't do. And we don't do Margaritaville. There's always some drunk chick wants to get up and say crazy. Absolutely, positively, no wagon wheel. No wagon wheel. Lost a drummer in Oklahoma, that's not hard. lost my heart up in Maine. Got subjected to a full body search down at LAX. Then they smashed my guitar on the plane. Thanks, United. Backstage, they've set out a science project. Round some parts, it's called a fruit tray. The sound man has smoked way too much reefer by the time it comes our turn to play. Yeah, our turn to play. It's always that way. Yeah, but we don't do Mustang Sally. And we don't do Margaritaville. There's always some drunk dude wants to get up and blow some harp with the band. Sorry, Gary. Absolutely positive.
No wagon wheel. Hey, can I blow some harp with you, dudes? Come on. I'm really good, man.
They got these nightclubs down in Hollywood, California. You want to work there, it's them you gotta pay. That's right. There's no extra charge for the break-in of the van. You got a shout-out from the stage for a place to stay. Anybody got a couch? So we ended up at this little soiree. Let's swing from the rafters, tear the joint down, down, down. A one-legged go-go dancer, man, she shot out the lights. And they arrested us and they took us all downtown. Yeah, we went downtown. Stood before the judge in the courtroom. Said, I'll let you go, you gotta do one thing for me. Get out your guitars, play my favorite song. Hey, you guys know Mustang Sally? Yeah, we don't do Mustang Sally, sorry man. And we don't do Margaritaville. Mustang Sally, and we don't do Margaritaville. There's always some drunk redneck wants to hear Sweet Home Alabama. Absolutely, positively, no wagon wheel.
No wagon wheel.
Here's the big end. G harmonica around there. Welcome back to the stage. Give him a big Genoa welcome. Direct from Cactus Pete's with Jack Papadon. That's right. He'll be here all week, folks, so stick around. These are musician jokes. I could go on and on. How come there's no banjos on Star Trek? Because it's the future.
Can I do a harmonica one?
Do a harmonica one. Here's
a harmonica joke. Why do harmonica players keep their harmonicas on the dashboard of their trucks?
I don't know. Why?
So they can park a handicap.
Oh. What do you call that girl on a banjo player's arm? A tattoo.
Come on, give me another one.
Here's one.
Let's swap
on. Here's one. I heard this in Texas. This is a true story. Down, I was playing the Alpine Festival, and Andy Hedges told me, he says, you know they got these metal detectors in every bar in Texas now. And I said, well, that don't sound right in this, you know, gun-loving state. How come? He said, it ain't for the guns. It's for the harmonicas.
What's the first thing a banjo player says when he goes to work? Would you like fries with that, sir? How do you get a banjo player off your front porch? Pay for your pizza? One more and I'll let you go. What's the definition of an optimist?
A banjo player with a beeper. That's it.
Okay, this is a song that I wrote that the Western Horsemen liked. They picked 13 cowboy songs they liked or something. It's very very subjective, but it's I appreciate the honor. I had two songs in there, and that's cool. My bank account didn't change. So don't worry, I'm still the same old me. I don't know, man, maybe it's early for this kind of humor. Anyway, it's called Don't Tell Me, and I'm gonna just spring it on him and he'll play it. Saddle my horse in darkness and trot out through the morning dew. I want to breathe some air it's never been breathed. And I want to drink the wine of freedom, toast the good ones that we knew. I want to count a million stars and think of you. I want to see one more hometown rodeo where it's hats off for the flag. Yeah, we cheered the bucking horse in the wild ride. I want to put a hole in my TV set and let the silence ring true. It's a good idea, huh? I want to count a million stars and think of you. So don't tell me that the West is dead and gone. My heart can't stand to hear that sad old song. If you're saying, son, yeah, you missed it all, here's hoping that you're wrong. Don't tell me it's dead and gone. I want to see one more Charlie Russell print some old rundown cafe. Yeah, where old men and coffee tell their tales. I wanna ride out with the wagon and the scent of the springtime sage. I wanna keep the wind in my back on down the trail. So don't tell me that the West is dead and gone. Cause my heart can't stand to hear that sad old song. Hoping that you're wrong. Don't tell me it's dead and gone. Cheeks and long braids, see the hat. Hear the summer rain on the roof at a country dance. And we're gonna ride out of raging storms till that old light comes shining through. And then we'll count a million stars and think of you. Don't tell me that the West is dead and gone. My heart can't stand to hear that sad old song. And if you're saying, son, that you missed it all, here's hoping that you're wrong. Don't tell me. Don't tell me. Don't tell me.
or something.
Yeah.
This is all technical music talk up here. It's like a band meeting. We just had a band meeting. Nobody got fired. Nobody's girlfriend came and cried. Threw a drink in someone's face. Didn't happen. I'm gonna do a Robert Johnson song, and Robert Johnson was like this guy that was like this incredible blues man that lived down in the South. And he's was influential character, and he was the real deal, you know, Robert Johnson. And he played in juke joints, etc., by himself on the guitar, and developed a beautiful guitar style like that. And he, I think he only recorded, in my blues experts here, was it 28 songs in his entire life?
I believe that's true.
Yeah, like 28 songs only for Robert Johnson, such an influential cat. And down in the South, you know, that's where they do crazy stuff like talking tongues and handle serpents and stuff. And so he made a deal with the devil to sell his soul. Don't mind those people behind the curtain. This show's right here. He sold it. Yeah, he sold his soul to the devil at the crossroads, the famous crossroads, and that's what he supposedly did a deal down at the crossroads. What state would that be, Gary?
That'd be down in Mississippi.
Mississippi. That's right.
And 41. The crossroads was 41. 61 and 49,
so that's it. Maybe something like that. He went down there and, you know, he did the deal. And he died a blues man's death. He was poisoned by a club owner and died alone in a hotel. That's serious stuff. That's the blues. It isn't Justin Bieber. It's serious, authentic stuff. That's why he could play so good. And this is a song of his. Sign.
take my life and never my sound. Look for a man, I got my 44 strapped to my side as I do. Horse Patrick. And Bill Dorrance was a very influential guy, and his brother Tom. Some people here may know their names. Yeah, maybe some people do. Yeah. Well, you guys gotta get with it, because these guys were amazing horsemen and cattlemen, and you know, it was before the internet, you know, so word was spread by word of mouth, and this guy named Ray Hunt that was very talented and pretty tough on the horses, but just had so much timing and beautiful stuff in him, you know, and he came to Bill Dorrance for some help, and Bill had been helping him, and he said he had this one horse named Hondu that he could, you know, like he won the Cow Palace on Hondu in the Bosal, and then, you know, the next day Hondu would buck his ass off, and he was missing something. And so he came to Bill, and Bill said, you know, this would be a good horse for my brother Tom to help you with. He'll be in town soon. And so they got together with Hondu. And Tom, he watched Ray ride Hondu. And Ray rode him for him. While around there, and he came back, and Tom said, well, that's the last thing that horse wants to do is buck. And Ray thought, this stupid old man, that's the first thing he wants to do. And Tom said, do you mind if I ride him? So Tom got on and rode him, and Hondu just, man, rode him about 10 minutes, and Hondu stretched out and took a leak. With Tom on his back, he had never ever felt secure enough to do that with Ray. And it was the beginning of this horse and Ray Hunt coming together. And so Ray really latched onto this approach that the Dorrances were sharing. And Ray got out, he was a road dog. He did clinics everywhere in America and in Australia and some in Europe.
And so there are people say, what are you doing? Because it really looked like something magical to these people. And I was living in Montana then, in the late 70s, and Ray Hunt came through there. I already known him from when I was younger in California. And he came through Montana doing clinics, and he was big in Montana and Idaho and Wyoming and Colorado. And so things started to kind of change, you know. But I remember seeing that when people were just like, they thought it was magic or something. It has nothing to do with magic. It's about life. Anyway, Bill had this one horse that came from somebody else. Somebody else had started it, and he was super tight. I mean, he was bothered. But he was very athletic, and he was a big, tall, rangy horse like Bill liked, kind of thoroughbred-looking horse. That was the beauty of Bill Dorrance, is someone else would look at this and go, this sumbitch is dangerous, he's going to hurt you. And Bill went, ooh, if I could ever get all that stuff working for me, I'd have quite a horse. So he turned that around, all these things, that all this life that was so close to the surface in this horse. He rode him in there. And this song takes place up on Mount Toro, beautiful Mount Toro. And the Santa Lucia Range, the highest mountain in the peak. You know, it's a peak. It's 3,710 feet right on the coast, though. You get up to the top of the Dorrance Ranch up from there, and you can look all the way down and see Big Sur and look north across the Monterey Bay to Santa Cruz and up over the Santa Cruz Mountains into Santa Clara County. And then you can look down the Salinas Valley, and you can see all the way over into San Benito County. It's beautiful. And I've been up there on Christmas Eve day, and when it's snowing in the Sierras, and you can see the Sierras from there. If it's clear enough, and it was. But anyway, it's a beautiful, that's where this song takes place, up on Mount Toro, the Dorrance Ranch. And so Bill was a family man. He was raising kids and cattle, and he wasn't a showman, but he did get Patrick kind of going, and he took him down to the, in 1957, to the Salinas Rodeo. And in the morning at the Salinas Rodeo, it's still there. It's a beautiful California setting. Big eucalyptus trees, and the fog's burning through the eucalyptus trees as the sun comes, warms it up, and they have a stock horse class there. They're showing horses in the bridle and the two rein and the snaffle bit, and they're working cows. And then they have the rodeo, you know, it's on the track in front there. And I would especially go to say, be bold enough to say, in 1957, the very best guys were there. The California guys were the best guys at that point. And maybe, you know, it's branched out some, but that's where they were. And it's very connected to Nevada, the Dorrance family and the whole thing. But anyway, all these guys were there, you know, the best guys and the best horses. And Bill loaded Patrick up in his old wooden horse trailer with the canvas roof and drove down to the Salinas Rodeo, and he won the bridle horse class on Patrick in the working cow horse class. And he, back then when you won, you didn't get a Tex-Dan saddle, you got a Garcia saddle order. So he ordered a Garcia saddle and always had that and rode it till he died. And on the back of the cattle board's a little engraved silver plate there. It says, first class, you know, first place. So Salinas Rodeo bridle horse class, Bill Dorrance hangs on there. Bill was an interesting guy. He was an old school dude, you know, and he was very, you know, when he said anything, it was worth listening to, believe me. But he was super old school. Like when I drive him, one of my chores was to drive him into town. I lived there with him. Now I look back, it was an old fashioned one-on-one apprenticeship. But back then, I had no idea what was going on. I was just wanted this really super bad, and to be around him, and for once I was in the right place at the right time, they became family to me and still are family. And Bill passed away at the age of 93, sharp as heck, but I drive him into town in his 65 Impala, because then he can sit over here on the passenger seat, and I drive him into town. And he, like when he saw, I remember once he saw this lady jogging down the road, and he said, why doesn't she just get a job? See, this stuff was so real, it went, most people couldn't handle it, you know.
And he was funny. He was funny. I got a million Bill Norton stories, but I'm never singing a song. But anyway, this is about Patrick. It's really about Bill. My name is Patrick, and I live in the mountains outside Salinas, way up in the sky. My name is Patrick, and the man who rides me, you know, he feels what I feel, and he thinks what I think. His touch goes down to my feet. Stop on 4 feet, no cow can get by me. And I'm straight up in the bridle, and my reins and riata, they're braided by the man I allow on my back, whose touch goes down. In Salinas, the great horses were there, and the men who rode them too. And I chased the wild cow, and I turned her on the fence, and the people all cheered, and they all looked at me. My name is Patrick, and I live in the mountains outside Salinas, way up in the sky. My name is Patrick, and the man who rides me, you know, he feels what I feel. And he thinks what I think, and his touch goes down to my feet. When I'm turned out in the golden hills, I eat the sweetest grass that grows under the oak trees, where the fog drips to the ground. and I sleep on the ridges where the wind off the ocean brings the scent of manzanita, and it blows through my mane.
Thank you. Let me get Gary up here. We'll do one more song, kind of wrap things up down here at the Big Revival Tent. I hope you guys found what you're looking for in here today. We're going to do one more. Where are you leaving? You got to go? What's the matter? Is it something I said? Yeah, okay.
It was because he invited me up.
Dude, no, they go, Gary's back. Let's get out of here. Now's our chance to go. One more time, Gary Allegretto. There we go. It's all covered. So those books, I picked one up. It was called Pulling Leather. And it was a wonderful story. I was pleasantly surprised. I laid down my $2.95, brought the book home, written by a guy named Reuben Mullins. And he came out and he cowboyed that a long time ago. Oh, it was about 1860. And he came out from back east. And it reminded me of my days in Nevada. I wrote it when I was kind of still down there in a lot of ways. And 110 years later, things haven't changed a whole lot about the way that we knew a cow. So I wrote this song. So it's a little bit of my life, a little bit of his. Must have been a pitiful sight, and I
moved all over the West, boys. I've traveled all over the West. Well, we rode wild calves flanking down and giving the boss a brand. Rode wild calves flanking down and giving the boss a brand. Yeah, the dust so thick, some burning down, it was all that I could stand. And I've rolled all over the West, boys. I've traveled all over the West. Two, one, two, three. I would have done that shit earlier. Well, the cook was mean and quite unclean. He dared not complain. Cook was mean and quite unclean. Dared not complain. He'd find your turn. Wrangle come again and again and again and again and again. Sort of like a moose-deer pie story. And I rode all over the West Fork. I've trod all over the world. Well, with 2 feet in the stirrups and one end on the reins. 2 feet in the stirrups and one end on the reins. The back of an old bay cowpony, its half saw the plains. And I rode all over the West Fork, trod all over the land. Rode all over the West Fork, trod all over the land. Thank you. Mike Beck.
Mike's got CDs for sale in the back, and so do I. We'll meet you back there.
I can't? What about the monitor? Okay.
The Punchy Blues, ladies and gentlemen. Have you heard anything like that before? No. Cowboy Festival?
Never
realized they practiced for about 5 minutes before they played the set. This is like being in Elko 25 years ago at 3 o'clock in the morning at Stockman's.